When you put a prism in a window and the sun shines through it, you'll get a pretty rainbow on your wall. It's nice to look at, but it's also important to understand as a gardener, because some of these colored wavelengths are very important for plant growth. So join me as I discuss plant growth and the importance of red light, blue light, and especially green light. Hi, I'm Gardener Scott. Most of the time when we're out gardening, we probably don't even think about the different color wavelengths that are hitting us and our plants. And it isn't until we use a prism to separate that white light into the many colors of the spectrum that maybe we'll stop and think about how those different color wavelengths affect our plants. There's a common assumption among gardeners and many professional growers that red light and blue light are the most important wavelengths for growing plants. And you may see professional operations where an entire warehouse is bathed in red light. It does affect the growth of plants, but you may notice that the grow lights I use are white light. So why do I use white light and a professional grower might use a red light? Research has shown that red light is very good for photosynthesis. Red light promotes germination, it makes leaves grow larger, and it can promote flowering among many plants. Along with blue light, which is also very good for photosynthesis, those two colors have really received the most attention in recent years. Even for home growers, you can now find grow lights that use blue LEDs and red LEDs to get the benefits of those two wavelengths. Today I'm at my buddy Steve's house and taking a look at his grow light setup. Now these are LED lights, and they have white LED lights to have the entire wavelengths, but they also have additional red LEDs and blue LEDs to focus those specific light wavelengths. Steve's LED lights have a switch to control the intensity. When you look at it in low mode, you can see the individual white LEDs, the blue LEDs, and the red LEDs. And all together, these work well for a grow light. But as pretty as those red and blue LEDs might be, I believe that white light is really the best way to go. And I have some university studies to back that up. Before I get to the university-based research, let me ask a simple question. Why are plants green? Well, the common understanding is that plants are green because the leaves and the stems are reflecting the green wavelength. Plants absorb other wavelengths, but because they're not absorbing green light and are reflecting it, they appear green to us. But it's not that simple. There have been many studies that have shown the effectiveness of green light and plant growth. One that I looked at from Utah State University focused on blue and green light and determined green is very important. I also looked at a study from the University of Wyoming that was focusing primarily on the fixation of green light in leaves, and it also determined that green light is very important for photosynthesis. I'll use this small pepper plant for example as I discuss how it basically works. This is a green plant with green leaves. And so when the light comes down and hits the top of the leaves, it's primarily the blue and the red wavelengths that are absorbed by these leaves. but it's only about the upper 20% of the leaf surface that is absorbing the red and the blue light. There's a lot more leaf cells involved. And what happens is that the green light can actually penetrate deeper into the leaf and promote more photosynthesis. Much research since the 1940s has confirmed that leaves do indeed absorb some green light. For a small plant like this, the red and the blue really does play an important role, because that red and that blue light can reach all of these young plants. And remember, those wavelengths are very efficient for photosynthesis. But where it becomes more important as far as the green light is concerned is when this plant gets bigger, because the red and the blue light would only be hitting the upper leaves and not penetrating deeper into the plant. And that gets back to my basic question of why plants are green. They do reflect some green wavelength light. So imagine a big plant. You have the light coming down from the sun. The green is penetrating into and through the leaves. And then because it's reflected, it's bouncing back and forth the lower part of the plant. So now the lower leaves that wouldn't normally be exposed to blue and red light are now exposed to green light. And because leaves can absorb green light for photosynthesis, the lower leaves now serve a purpose and benefit the plant. I know this science is probably hurting your head, but the point I'm trying to make is that red light and blue light by themselves are not enough to really benefit our plants. Research has shown, and you can probably find some of these videos on YouTube, that blue light by itself and red light by itself will allow plants to grow, but they're going to be deformed, misshapen. They're not going to look like the plant we expect. And even blue light and red light together do not produce a normal plant. The only way to get a normal plant like we think it should look is to have red light and blue light and green light working together. It is the full spectrum of light that benefits plants the most. It's no coincidence that when color televisions were developed, they used those three colors, blue, red, and green, to make white. This is why I use white light, because it includes the green and the red and the blue wavelengths. That's what's coming from the sun as well, and that's what plants are expecting. Yes, red wavelengths are the most efficient for photosynthesis. But photosynthesis is not everything when it comes to plants. There are many other factors at play, and the other wavelengths affect plants in ways beyond just the simple photosynthesis. So why have I gone into all this scientific explanation? It's because I see a lot of gardeners spending a lot of money on the blue lights or the red lights and expecting something super to happen to their plants. Now, my buddy Steve's lights have the red and the blue, but they also have that white component. So it is a good blend. When you're looking at grow lights, keep that in mind. The red is good, but don't forget the white when it comes to plant growth. I'm content with my basic T5 fluorescent bulbs. They give me full spectrum of light, and they're very affordable. If you have any questions about how wavelengths affect your plants, please let me know below. If you've used red light or blue light or both, I'd like to hear how you've learned that they affect your plants. Do you like them or not? If you'd like to have more gardening information, Well, now's the time to subscribe to the Gardner Scott channel if you haven't already done so. And if you like this video, you can give me a thumbs up and share it. I'm Gardner Scott. Enjoy gardening.